Foxes are probably one of our major pests, being livestock. They definitely do have an impact on our lambing. Even ewes getting down to lamb, they'll eat their udders off and, you know, make them so they're no good anymore. We choose to shoot to control them. We've got too many good dogs to muck around with baits. They're a bit more dangerous. We still lose probably 40% of the lambs with no actual visual sightings of dead lambs on the ground, so obviously they've been taken. Shooting of any animal isn't the greatest thing, but it's just got to be done. We're getting less foxes each time we go shooting, so this seems to be reducing the numbers, but time will tell. Group effort is definitely the way to go, because obviously you're covering a lot bigger area at one hit. It's certainly having an impact. This year we've got 450 in the Brookshire, but on our place alone we only got 19 compared to the 48 the year before, so we thought that was quite good that we've reduced our numbers.
Blackwood Biosecurity Inc. is a relatively new biosecurity group. We were formed in 2015 out of a public meeting of concerned landowners and other stakeholders. We are a non-for-profit organisation managed by a great group of about 12 volunteers, all with a combined very large knowledge of natural resource management issues and biosecurity issues within the region. As an RBG, we don't do work for people, but we're there to give them advice as a conduit between information from science, the latest research and development, the Department of Agriculture, so education and support. Our role too is to encourage people to take an integrated approach to all pest management. There's not one silver bullet cure for any of the pest species. It's a matter of a hard slog. You don't just do one thing for them, you need to do a combination, a cocktail of activities.
So in the past, there was a statutory process in place which had the Agricultural Protection Board established. And now we're working with individual communities who recognise some of the declared pests that are in their areas as real issues for them and for industry members. So we're working with them to establish, to set their priorities, and then to work towards becoming recognised by the Minister.
DAFWA supports the recognised biosecurity groups by being available to help them with any of their issues around governance, around group work, around brokering information on best practice management. We also work across the whole of the southwest of WA, where we've started to help any groups and communities that want to become recognised. So if a group is recognised, that means that they have legitimacy with their community and they're able to then work on particular declared pest species that they and their community have chosen as the priority.
One of the things about establishing a biosecurity group, it gives community greater input in what they want done in their area. So in the past, the department's done whatever we've had the resources for and what we saw as priorities. But this throws it back to the community and say, well, you let us know what your priorities are. We'll support you with the priorities. They've got local knowledge. They know what's impacting their area the most. So they're in the best place to make those decisions about what they want to see happen in the area.
For the Eastern Wheatbelt group, wild dogs is very much an issue. Our role is to help them through the process, guide them through the declared pest rate and how that goes through, and just basically ensure that they have the support that they need to work in the community and also information to be able to manage the pests.
The Eastern Wheatbelt Biosecurity Group's been in operation for about 15 years. Well, the majority of the Eastern Wheatbelt were from Lake Grace up to the Shire of Mount Marshall, and then all along that eastern side towards the State Barrier Fence. The Eastern Wheatbelt Biosecurity Group was established as there was a wild dog problem. They were losing approximately 2,000 head of sheep to wild dogs. Over the years, they've reduced that down to about 50 head of sheep per year by contracting to licensed pest management technicians. In 2014, the group became recognised by the Minister, and from that, the group could consult with Minister to implement a declared pest rate. Last year, the rate was put forward, and each of the landholders within the prescribed area of the Eastern Wheatbelt Biosecurity Group received a declared pest rate notice, and then they funded the group from that.
That's probably one of the key strengths of recognised biosecurity groups. It's community driven, local people making local decisions, and it's the opportunity to create a declared pest rate and then have matching funds from the government.
The funding that the groups end up with through the declared pest rate can be used for a whole range of things, such as community engagement around pest management, focus on some of the pests themselves, such as wild dogs. In areas in the southwest, they've got a strong focus on cotton bush, and so they use that to engage and coordinate the community, to make people aware of the effects of cotton bush and what the landholders' responsibilities are.
Nungarran Shire is a member of the Eastern Wheatbelt Biosecurity Group. There's actually quite a few other shires involved in it as well, and we've found, though we occasionally have a dog problem here, it's quite rare, and the reason for that is that most of our problems are stopped before they get here by the fact that the Eastern Wheatbelt Biosecurity Group has a dog or has two doggers working along the fence. They maintain the fence and they bait and shoot and trap dogs along the fence, and that basically stops them getting this far and becoming our problem.
Previously we'd get, you know, 100, 150 dogs a year, each dogger. Now they've dropped off down to, you know, between 20 to 25 trapped. The main idea is to patrol the fence, create a dog-free barrier, which at this stage is we're still working on. It's a work in progress.
The fact that the cost is able to be spread across the entire community really makes it a much more viable option than if just those landholders really who are on the fence had to bear the cost.
Since we've been working in this space over the last 5 years or so, there's been a number of successes that we are looking at. There are a number of groups that have been recognised by the Minister. A rate is being established in some of those areas, but more importantly, the management of the pests has really made inroads into their impact. And that can be attributed to the establishment of biosecurity groups within the area who are really active and working across the landscape and working with community members.
Controlling pests is a necessary part of farming. Definitely good having a local group because they're dealing with the problems that are relevant to our area. I think it's our responsibility each generation to manage the pests. I know my father has before me and his father, so I owe it to the next generations to keep the pests under control.